So we made it to Birmingham.
Finally made it.
8 hours it took us, and it would usually take us 4 hours. So yes, that was a stressful day, very stressful. But we're here.
We've got here.
She's got the first layer of tan on.
Don't know if you can. You won't be able to see.
It's quite dark. Bearing in mind how pasty she was before. Oh, that's just how tan I am.
I was white before.
Pretty tan.
My arm looks quite skinny now.
But yeah, so venue looks good.
Yeah, venue looks good. Well, I was actually going to be really impressed after our last tube of how crap the last accommodation was.
Oh yeah.
Did good on this
one. Did very good.
Did good. We have
basically a little room, little kitchenette.
And it's only like 2 minutes from the venue, so we can walk.
Yes.
So I pulled that back.
It means I don't have to get up and drive around the city, which is nice. I can sleep in.
Yeah. So negative one for the last place. Positive one for this one.
So we've evened out.
Oh, what?
But we've just done a little check-in, haven't we?
Yeah.
And she's looking very good. Very good compared to last time. She's got the glute lines there.
Got to not stress.
Got to not stress tomorrow. What's the position for tomorrow? What are you going to do all day? Just got to practice it. That's it.
I best not put my tiny feet up against the wall though.
That's what she's going to be doing all day. Keeping her legs up,
well,
relaxing.
Until about 12, that's
chilling.
Where my top coat is.
Yeah, until then. But that's the game plan. But yeah, so just got to continue drying her out now.
Yep.
A little bit of wine going in.
God, I don't know about anyone else, but I hate wine.
She literally
absolutely
hate wine. She nearly threw up last
time. Matt was telling me to stop last time. I was like, I don't like wine.
Oh, funny.
Give me chocolate. I'll keep going. Matt can't handle too much sugar. He's a big wimp. I had to be careful with my words then. It's like, you can't handle too much sugar and I tell you to suck it up, but I can't handle alcohol.
She has to bring me into it, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Right, let's give her some wine. Yeah.
And in third place, number 76, Shelby Cole. In second place, number 45, Laura Wilkin. And the winner and receiving a pro status, number 31, Georgia. Water turns to your right, please. Water soaks to our right hand. Water soaks to your right hand. Okay, ladies, face the back of the stage, please. Walk to the back of the stage. Hold the back post of the counter to turn around and come back, ladies. Thank you.
So, we are out, but we're not done.
We're not done yet.
What happened, George?
I won my class.
Woo!
Unexpectedly ended up in athletic. We weren't sure if I should do athletic or bikini, but athletic was before bikini. So I didn't want to risk doing bikini, and they didn't like my look for bikini because it's very conflicting. I'm on the edge with like my delts, whether I am bikini or whether I am athletic, and every federation is different. So we took the risk to do athletic.
Literally last minute decision.
Like I had a playlist for my stress. I had a routine backstage. I just had my makeup, just sat down, and then we had this idea, and I had one class, and then I was backstage, and I was like, oh my God.
Yeah,
I am now
she was literally
on.
Thinking about it, and then she was like, right, well, if you're doing it, you need to go backstage now and start pumping.
And I just started having a panic attack because this wasn't in line with my de-stress backstage routine.
Which looks
incredible. I didn't have my playlist, but yeah, we went on, and so they said, because of doing the athletic, don't do bikini. So I haven't done the bikini class, but it's always going to depend on federations, so I'm always just going to have to check what I, it's not to say I never fit bikini now, it's just what each federation class as athletic and bikini, so.
Yeah, but end of the story is she won, she got a pro card, so she's going back on.
So yeah, there's a pro show this evening, so I'm doing the pro athletic, and just see how we get on.
Go on, Georgia! Yes!
In second place, number 72, Sarah Duffy.
Well done,
Sarah! Which is the winner of Go Athletic, coming back in the overalls. Number 31, Georgie.
Well done, Sarah!
Come on, George! Yes! Well done, Georgia!
Thank you. us to the back of the stage, please.
Come on, Georgia! Yes!
Okay, ladies, I'll explain exactly the same as what I did to the guys. This is the potential for taking you to America, so we judge it on the context of who we feel will do the most damage in America. And I have to say, if this is the pro lineup I've got for the women, it's a problem I'm happy to have every single show. So congratulations, all of you. Fantastic turnout. Unfortunately, only three of you can place in this, and it was very, very close between all of us. But we only have three trophies. In third place, number 65, Natalie Luce. In second place, number 31, Georgia Gilbert. Oh, so much for coming and doing the pro show. Fantastic turnout, really proud of you. But the winner joining us in Galveston, Texas in December. Fucking hear a pin drop. Well, I'll be dying that all day. Will be number 45, Laura Wilkins.
If you saw my last story and then or last YouTube and then you follow me on Instagram, you'll see that with FITX, it was a day that I learned a lot from. So I stress really got to me, it really, really did. And we had a few things that we needed to take away. We had some things that we were gonna implement moving forward. One of the biggest things was a backstage or a pre-show day stress
routine, little pre-show,
yeah,
routine,
just to really control my stress. And it worked out quite well for the first half of the day, so I knew I wasn't going to be on till about like 3:30, and my tan wasn't, top coat wasn't until 12, makeup at 1, so I stayed in the hotel room all morning, feet up, watching Netflix, not thinking about anything, just really, really, really keeping my water levels down from stress, because We've compared photos and stress took its toll on FITX day. It was something we needed to control. And then so got to the venue, had my tan. Jesus Christ. Had my tan. And then I had my makeup. Makeup was running a bit late, and then I just sat down, and one of my friends was like, I'm wondering whether you should do athletic bikini, purely because I'm always unsure with some federations what I am, because some federations want a little bit more muscle for bikini, some federations quite slim girls, and I can be a bit too muscular, so the worry was bikini was on last. If they did find I was too muscular for that class, I would have missed my opportunity to do the other class. So it was a bit of a panic. We got thrown into athletic last minute because the idea was if I was too small for athletic, they'd throw me out again and they'd say go into bikini later in the day.
It was literally so last minute, wasn't it?
I just sat down, we made this decision, someone asked if I should do it, they said yes, threw me in it and said you need to be backstage in 5 minutes. And I was like, oh my God, this does not go with my backstage zen. I hadn't even had my bikini on. Oh, it was so stressful. I had got a Spotify playlist with Arnold Schwarzenegger telling me it was going to be all fine. I didn't even have my headphones. I was trying to pump up and I was so stressed backstage, but I had Imogen and Katie backstage and they were my lifesavers. They really helped keep me calm. So I went on to athletic. Unsure what the hell was even going to happen, and I ended up winning athletic, which was absolutely insane. So I got my pro card for athletic. I stuck to Diva because you could enter a few classes providing you fit the category. So again, FITX, I learned that I needed to be a lot more confident. Like I said, stress, anxiety, everything took over. I'm not a natural born person on stage. So entering Diva, this is a class based all around SAS. So I spent the last 5 weeks finding my inner SAS and working out how to be more confident. So I didn't expect anything in that one either. It was just a chance for me to get more stage experience. And I got third in that, and there was about 9 or 10 girls in that class. So that really surprised me. So I did find some sass, so that's good. And then ended up staying on for the pro show just to see. Again, more stage experience. Why not? Again, no expectations. So into the athletic bikini pro show, up against a few other pro athletic bikini athletes. Ended up winning that one, which is absolutely insane. So then I went into the pro overalls. So it's all the pro women athletes. So it's figure, bikini pros, athletics, all of us. There was how many of us? Like,
I don't know, probably maybe
14 or 15. Women's pros on stage and all category, all pro winners. And I was like, oh, what am I doing? Went on there and ended up coming second overall. So my mind was just blown for it all. And it was so good as well because it was such a late class. And we know my body holds so much. I've got this bounce all over the place. My body holds so much water the more the day goes on. So this again, as well as stress, is something we really, really, really had to try and control. And we managed it quite well, really. Yeah, like, considering the pro shows were like 7-8 o'clock in the evening, and I still had some leg lines. So that's really promising moving forward. So it was such a fun show. And of course we had Domino's, we had cookies and donuts, and it's just been, I feel like I've just got life in me again, which is so nice. So yeah, now the plan is 3 weeks mentally and physically. It is very much needed to kind of chill, unwind, not go into full potato mode. because after this, I then go back into prep, but it's going to be like an 8 week prep into Tuberose. So my body definitely needs this right now. I've given myself So Saturday night was the end of the show, Sunday and Monday to just fully enjoy, because mentally it is just, like I said, needed. And then from Tuesday we go back into a bit of a routine, but bumped calories, just keep an eye on myself, but just have some flexibility. And then yeah, just see how we go over the next 3 weeks. And then we go again and we have to push even harder. I have to bring the conditioning even more for Two Bros. So yeah, it's gonna be challenging. It's such a short space of time. So yeah, we're gonna keep a very close eye on things.
We know what we need to work on.
Yep.
And we know how your body works.
We've got a better understanding of how my body works because we just changed so much since the X. Yeah. And just for the first 5 months of my prep, it's my plan's gonna be so different now, even more so than it was before. So fingers crossed, this is just what my body needs now. It needs that break, it needs to chill. And then it just means that it's gonna be really ready to go into prep again because you can't keep running yourself into the ground. So yeah. Very excited for some flexibility. I have my hen do in these next few weeks. We've just got wedding stuff to sort. We've got
busy. Just
got to live a life again for a bit before you get back on prep, because prep is a very selfish sport. So yeah, have a little bit of socialization.
Well, what's very exciting is we're back in Birmingham again next weekend.
Back in Birmingham next weekend because our client Millie is competing in the PCA First Timers. So we are, we're going around the corner. Very much looking forward to that. She has absolutely killed it. So she's going to look amazing on stage. So yeah, very, very busy.
Yeah.
Anything else you want to add in?
No, just that I'm very, very proud of you. You smashed it.
Worked so hard. It was also worth it. It was such a fun day.
Ultimate comeback story. From no
placement, comeback.
Not really looked at FITX, to coming away, making the changes we needed to make, dropped in, coming more conditioned, smashed the nerves. So we basically did everything we wanted to do, and you come away with pro status, winning the pro show and coming second in overalls. So that's how much a difference can make once you learn how the body basically responds to certain things and the adjustments that's needed in the plan. Just proves that one size fits all doesn't work for everyone. You need to adjust it for the individual.
And mindset's such a big thing. I could have come off stage at FITX, had a sulk because it didn't go my way, or you go, do you know what, we got work to do, how are we going to make this work? And that's what we did.
Good
job. That's everything. So yeah, we'll leave you in peace now because it's been longer than planned, and we will get to work on the next one. And we will see you in the next one.